हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एनसीईआरटी क्लास 8 साइंस एमसीक्यूज पार्ट 2 ऑफ द वीडियो। पार्ट 1 इज ऑलरेडी अपलोडेड इन द चैनल। सो दीज एमसीक्यूज आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम्स एज एनसीईआरटी प्ले अ इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन द एमसीक्यू सीरीज इन द गवर्नमेंट एग्जाम। सो लेट्स लुक इनटू द एमसीक्यूज। नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, which gas is produced with the burning of coal? Let's look into the options. Option A, SO2. Option B, H2SO4. Option C, CO2. Or option D, methane. So the gas which is used while burning the coal is, the correct option is option number C, that is CO2. So CO2 is the correct option. Option C is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 2. Which of the following is known as black gold? Let's look into the options. Option A, petroleum. Option B, coal. Option C, granite. Or option D, none of the above. So black gold is also refers to, the correct option is option number A, that is petroleum. So petroleum is known as black gold. So correct option is option A, petroleum. Now let's move to question number 3. Question number 3, in which country world's first oil well was discovered? So let's look into the options. Option A, Russia. Option B, China. Option C, India. Or option D, United States of America. So the world first country, so the world's first country where oil well was discovered is, the correct option is option number D, that is United States of America. So USA is the world's first country where oil well was discovered. So D is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 4. Which of the following gas is used in fire extinguisher? Let's look into the options. Option A, CO2. Option B, SO2. Option C, H2O. Or option D, HNO3. So in fire extinguisher, the gas which is used is, the correct option is CO2. So CO2 is there present in the fire extinguisher in the liquid form, and then when it is released from the extinguisher, it then converted into gaseous form. So CO2 is the correct option. Now question number 5, consider the following statements. Statement A, the biosphere reserves help to maintain the biodiversity and culture of that area. Statement B, a biosphere reserve may also contain other protected areas in it. Which of the following above statement or statements is or are correct? Let's look into the options. Option number 1, only A is correct. Option number 2, only B is correct. Option number 3, both A and B is correct. Or option number 4, none of the above. So when it comes to the biosphere reserves are basically help to maintain the biodiversity and culture of that area, because number of animals and plants are found there. So statement A is correct. Also, when it comes to statement B, also considered as other protected areas in biosphere reserve. So when it comes to the statements, so statement A is the correct statement, as biosphere reserve helps to maintain the biodiversity and the culture. Also, biosphere reserve also contains other protected areas. So statement B is also correct. So as both the statements above are correct, so the correct option is option number 3, that is both A and B. So both A and B is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 6. Which of the following is the first reserve forest of India? Let's look into the options. Option A, Dudhua National Park. Option B, Satpura National Park. Option C, Kanha National Park. Or option D, Jim Corbett National Park. So the first protected, the first reserve forest of India is, the correct option is option A, that is Satpura National Park. So Satpura National Park is the first reserve forest of India. So option B is the correct option. Now let's move to question number 7. What is the SI unit of force? Let's look into the options. Option A, Newton. Option B, Ampere. Option C, Coulomb. Or option D, Pascal. So the SI unit of force is, the correct option is option A, that is Newton. Now let's move to question number 8. In which of the following coal tar is used? Let's look into the options. Option A, paints. Option B, drugs. Option C, perfumes. Option D, metalling the road. So when it comes to the uses of coal tar, coal tars are used in paints. So A is correct. Also, coal tar is used in drugs. B is also correct. Also, in the metalling of the roads. So D is also correct. And we have also seen that coal tar is also used in perfumes. So as all the above options are correct, in all the above options coal tar are used. So the correct option is option number 4. That is all of the above. So all of the above is the correct option. Now let's come to question number 9. The amount of heat energy produced on complete combustion of 1 kg of a fuel is called its calorific value. The calorific value of a fuel is expressed in a unit. What is the name of the unit? Let's look into the options. Option A, Newton per Coulomb. Option B, kilojoule per kg. Option C, Pascal per second. Or option D, none of the above. So the calorific value is calculated or expressed in a unit. The name of the unit is kilojoule per kg. So option B is the correct option, that is kilojoule per kg. Now let's move to question number 10. What are the three essential requirements for producing fire? Let's look into the options. Option A, fuel, temperature and air. Option B, fuel, light and heat. Option C, fuel, air and heat. Or option D, none of the above. So if we look into the essential requirements for producing fire, first requirement is a fuel. It means that the source through which the fire will be generated. So fuel is totally correct. Also, once the fire will be generated, it requires a medium to spread. So air is also one of the essential requirements for producing fire. Through air only the fire will get much more intense and through heat the fire will get much more intense, and then it will be spreading the lights and all things. So fuel, air and heat is the correct sequence. So statements option number C is the correct option, that is fuel, air and heat. These are the essential requirements for producing fire. Now let's move to question number 11. Which of the following device is used to measure magnitude of the earthquakes? Let's look into the options. Option A, seismograph. Option B, Richter scale. Option C, Mercalli scale. Or option D, none of the above. So the device which is used to measure the magnitude of the earthquake is, the correct option is option B, that is Richter scale is the device which is used to measure the magnitude of the earthquakes. So option B is the correct option. Now let's move to the last question of this video, question number 12. Question number 12, which of the following statement is correct with respect to carbonation? Let's look into the statements. Statement A, process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal. Statement B, process of conversion of dead vegetation into petrol. Statement C, process of conversion of dead vegetation into natural gas. Or statement D, all of the above. So when it comes to the process of carbonation, the correct option will be statement A, that is process of conversion of dead vegetation into coal is known as carbonation. So I hope that you have liked the quality of the question. Do subscribe to my channel and please press the like button. Thank you.